हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। वंस अगेन आई एम बिफोर यू विद द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ फोर्थ लेसन ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर ऑफ क्लास 10। माय डियर, द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज फ्रॉम द डायरी ऑफ एन फ्रैंक। वेरी इंस्पायरिंग लेसन it is, my dear, and you will surprise to know the way of living of a 13-year-old Jewish girl named Anne Frank. She was born on 12th June 1929, and since then, you may tell it, she suffered a lot, and even she did a lot in a very short period of her life. This lesson is taken from a very famous book, and it is The Diary of a Young Girl. As the title is, let us justify whether it is apt or not. As here we have an extract from the famous book, a very famous piece of writing. And actually, I would like to say, diary writing is really a strange thing. I would like to have a little bit of discussion. Why do we people write the pages of diaries? It is because we want to express whatsoever we feel, and we are not in position to express before anyone. As here in the story, Anne Frank said, paper has much more patience than a person. Of course, I agree with the matter, and I see what is described on the page of our diary. It remains silent till others open it and unfurl it for kind understanding. So I think the title is quite apt and justified. Other thing about the background of the character of Anne Frank. Very frankly, she has described her feelings, her bad days, the migration of her father and mother. She has also described her living along with her grandmother, and in what way her community was being tortured. My dear, we people can imagine only. As her community, I mean Jewish, they were being tortured by the Nazi, and its head very cruelly they were treated. They were kept in a detention center where life was always on a stake. They had no option rather than to bear what was happening with them. In such a situation, you may imagine in what way the girl faced and described very stealthily what she felt. Let us know her family background. As she was born on 12 June 1929 at Frankfurt in Germany, and it is very shocking to know she died in 1941. In this very short span of life, she suffered only, and other curious thing of her life was that she was very talkative. So even in her classroom, she was tortured by the teacher, Mr. Kissing. It is another aspect. But before that, we must know her father, Otto Frank, migrated to Holland in 1933. And her mother, Edith Hollander Frank, also migrated along with him, means with her husband, and settled. At that time, Anne Frank was only 4 years old, and she was left to her grandmother to continue. And other thing, she had much more love for her father. She said, I quote, "My father is the most adorable father in the world." Of course, my dear, this is very heartiest expression by the character about the father. We have our fathers, and we all very happily may consider this statement is quite true. We should only consider our parents that they are very fine. They fulfill our all sorts of requirement. They look after and provide opportunity for the rest of life. As she could not deny, so we should not deny. And after that, she joined the company of her parents and was sent in a Montessori school. Later, her grandmother died, and after that, she remained with her parents. But after that, she was a mature and an intelligent girl. Her maturity kept her away from danger, and very secretly she expressed her feeling in the page of her diary. She was quite unknown whether the pages of my diary would be read or not. We also do not know whether the pages of our diary would be read. But for our own satisfaction, we describe our feeling in words. And I think she learned to maintain a diary. And by means of it, she did. In our next discussion, we shall exchange our view about the matter described in her diary. My dear, nowadays, as in my every video lecture, I share about the fear that has come and has settled in our mind. We must keep it away, especially to you all students, because a healthy mind lives in a healthy body. So I would like to advise to stay at home, live fearlessly, and connect yourself for the investment of time you have. Without doing better, we cannot expect for a very bright future. And I think my advice would be followed, because we teachers always wish you, bless you, and hope that my students will certainly do better and would become a very good citizen for the nation. So with these words of consolation, I would like to encourage you once again, and would like to see you following you in the course of development in a very constructive way. Thank you.